Bowling Green men's basketball looking for their best start since the 2019-2020 season, hosting the Buffalo Bulls looking to end an 8-game losing streak. Welcome into the Stroh Center here on a Tuesday evening for some MAC men's basketball. Joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Cavillitz, and Holden, this Bowling Green team coming off their third loss in the past four games against Central Michigan last game. They fell in double overtime to the Chippewas, 77-76. What happened to Bowling Green that has now, after starting 5-1 in MAC play, you're looking at a team that's sitting 6-4 in MAC play now in fourth place in the conference?
Yeah, they're really just starting to struggle in those closing moments of the game. And that's two of those four losses have been in overtime. And like you said, despite starting with one of the better records in the conference, they're certainly skidding now, and tonight would definitely be one they'd like to have to get back in the win column.
Coach Simon, post-game, said it was an unacceptable effort defensively. Falcons team defense was one of the strengths for most of the season. They've kind of faltered as of late in MAC play. That was their first double overtime game since the 2016-2017 campaign. And they have now really kind of just found themselves towards the middle of the pack in the MAC. However, they've had some guys really step up as they've been a little shorthanded due to injuries. Sam Towns ultimately came back a few games ago. But you look at this roster, you have guys that have really stepped up. Specifically, we're talking about Rashawn Agee and Marcus Hill.
Yeah, the two of those have been majorly contributing in the spots that they've needed them, and when some others maybe aren't getting it done as much as a team would like them to.
Marcus Hill had a season-high 7 assists last game against Central Michigan. He's now had 7 straight 20-plus point performances. That's the longest active streak in the nation. And Rashawn Agee is a starter to do Rashawn Agee things. So now we're going to switch it over to Buffalo. And this is a team that really has yet to find their footing this season.
They are also under their first-year head coach, George Halevich. But they are not finding nearly the same kinds of success that the Falcons have had so far under their first-year head coach, Todd Simon. And as you said, losers of 8 straight, they would certainly like to get back on track, but it's not looking like a very simple task for them.
Yeah, like you said, new head coach. They were picked 9th in the preseason poll. Were picked to be a team that towards the bottom, but I don't think anyone expected them to be sitting here on February 6th, 2-19 overall and 1-8 in the MAC. Like we've mentioned a couple times now, the 8-game losing streak. Their game that they last won was actually against Central Michigan, who is now 2nd in the MAC. And before that game, they lost 9 in a row. So this is the team you're looking at has really not seen a win in a long, long time. But what has gone so wrong for Buffalo this season that not only are they last in the MAC, but 2 wins in 21 games?
Well, I think one of the biggest things to look at is their margin of turnovers. They average 14.9 turnovers a game, and that's the worst in the MAC, and that's just not a recipe to winning basketball.
And you also look at those stats. This is a team taking the most three-pointers per game in the MAC. They like to shoot from the outside. However, there's one problem with that. They have been the 5th worst three-point shooting team in the entire nation this season.
And that goes hand-in-hand with their turnover struggles, too. When you're turning over the ball as often as the Bulls are, you have to be able to maximize the possessions that you've got. And when they're not doing that and they're taking threes at the volume they do and not converting on them, that's just a recipe for failure.
Defense has also been a struggle for them. It's not only the offense. Right now they're allowing 80 points a game. Teams are shooting nearly 50% from the field and over 36% from beyond the arc. They're the 4th worst team, if you just go by field goal percentage, in the nation. So what do you need to see from them tonight if they're looking to stop this Falcons offense, which has been averaging the most points per game in MAC play?
They need to stay locked in on their game plan. They can't have guys making mistakes and giving up points that don't need to be given up, to be simple.
If you look at last game for Buffalo, they faced off against Kent State, a team that Falcons had a pretty good game with here at the Stroh Center not too long ago. Kent State beat the Falcons here in overtime, but they fell to the Golden Flashes by 31 last game, 83-52. They were outscored by Kent State 51-22 in the first half. So defensively and offensively, what do you need to see from this Buffalo team coming out of the gates in this one?
Out of the gate, they need to just establish the kind of momentum they want. They need to set the tone, not start taking shots mindlessly and just putting up random three-pointers that they're not expecting to go, not get desperate, just stay calm, stick to their plan, and try and limit the Falcons' offense while getting buckets of their own, which sounds silly enough to say like that, but it's what you have to do. You can't start out with a large deficit and allowing a lot of points and expect to be able to just save yourself in the second half from those mistakes.
When you look at that Buffalo roster, there's two or three big guys that stick out on that. What are the names that stick out to you for this Bulls team that have really been the main contributors for this team so far?
Cy Chapman is a big one. He's leading them in points per game with 18.1. And on top of that, Janivius Smith has been big for them, their most efficient shooter. Those are really the main two that stick out on an otherwise, frankly, struggling team.
All right, we're going to take a couple-minute break and then be right back closer to tip-off, just about 10 minutes away from tip-off here at the Stroh Center for Bowling Green men's basketball against the Buffalo Bulls. Don't go anywhere.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack, and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit DrinkTap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
When someone hears the words, "you have cancer," it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Welcome back into the Stroh Center. Just about 5 minutes away from tip-off between Bowling Green men's basketball and the Buffalo Bulls. Joined by Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Kavlitz, and Holden, we do have the starting lineups in now. For Bowling Green, it's going to be a different lineup, actually, for the first time in conference play. It's going to be Marcus Hill, the junior guard from Rockford, Illinois. Trey Thomas, the senior guard from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, played at Vanderbilt past three seasons. Rashawn Agee, the big man down low, 6'8" forward from Chicago, Illinois. Jason Spurgeon, the 7-footer from the land down under, will be the center. And then new to the starting lineup is going to be DeJuan Humphrey. Deshaun Phillip had started every MAC game before this one. This will be the first time Humphrey gets the starting nod in conference play. And then over on Buffalo side, it's going to be Cy Chapman, the 5th-year forward from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Joining him is going to be Sean Faulcher, the sophomore guard from Brooklyn, New York. Jonivia Smith will be down low, the big 6'9" forward. Joining them will be Ryan Sable, the 6'3" freshman guard. And rounding out their starting five will be the 6'6", 210-pound senior forward, Isaiah Adams. So interesting for Todd Simon to stick DeJuan Humphrey into the starting lineup. Why do you think he made that change after starting Deshaun Phillip every MAC game up until this one?
The Falcons have had a solid MAC record, but when you look at losing 3 out of 4, two of them in very close efforts in overtime, you tend to think there may be some things to reevaluate. And in particular, I reckon against a team like Buffalo, where all logic says that the Falcons should probably be able to take care of business tonight, it's probably one of their safer games to try different things, experiment a little, see if they can get a little something going and kind of get back on track to where they'd like to be.
And I really do think that's probably what Simon's trying here. Humphrey, during non-conference play, shot 39% beyond the arc. Since conference play started, he's made just 8 three-pointers and shot 27.6% on three-pointers. So it may be Todd Simon trying to get him going moving into the back end of this MAC schedule. Like you said, 3 out of 4, they've lost. They want to get a little kickstarter there. And then anything stick out to you on Buffalo side?
Not in particular. It kind of lines up with what is expected. And again, I feel like the story is maybe less about them tonight and more about what version of the Falcons we see.
All right, so we're just under 2 minutes until tip-off now. We're going to take a break, let the pregame player introductions go on, and we'll be back for tip-off between Bowling Green men's basketball and the Buffalo Bulls. You're listening to BGSU men's basketball on Falcon Radio. Don't go anywhere.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
When someone hears the words, "You have cancer," it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack, and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack, and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
Thank you. seconds away from getting underway here at the Stroh Center. Player introductions finishing up for Bowling Green. And we'll get tip-off between the Falcons and the Bulls. So right before that, Holden, what are going to be your final keys to the game for both the Falcons and the Bulls if they want to come out with a victory in this one?
For me, the key for both teams is actually going to be the same today. It's who can start strong and get off on the right foot and do the things that they want to do out of the gate. Setting the tone early is going to be absolutely crucial for them to have success in this game tonight.
Bowling Green, when they lead at halftime, 10-1. Buffalo, when they trail at halftime, 0-17. We'll see who's able to jump ahead. Buffalo is going to be wearing their black jerseys with white numbering and white lettering. The blue stripping down the sides, and then Bowling Green will be going with their white uniforms here today with the Falcon script across the chest and some orange trim down the sides. Bowling Green will be going from left to right on your radio dial. Buffalo from right to left. Rashawn Agee and Jonavius Smith. At the Bowling Green logo in the middle of the court. Falcons really have been a second-half team for most of this season, so we'll be able to see if they can jump out ahead. They win the tip. Trey Thomas will bring it up for the orange and brown. Thomas passes out to Humphrey. Back to Thomas on the right wing. Humphrey, top of the arc, into Marcus Hill, fakes the shot, driving to the paint, out to the right. Surveying, looking to get into the paint. He'll put up a layup, and that'll go off the right hand. Marcus Hill gets the Falcons up on the board first. 2-0 Bowling Green. Buffalo with the ball. Jonavius Smith almost loses it. He'll be passed inside to Isaiah Adams. He'll survey back out to the left. Drive in left side. Left-handed floater will not go. Rashawn Agee with his first rebound of the night. Agee will bring it up the court the other way. Out to Humphrey. He'll get double-teamed to Spurgeon. And he'll try to swing a pass around to Trey Thomas on the left corner, but won't be able to handle that one. First turnover of the game for BG. So now we'll have a slight timeout here. Marcus Hill tying his shoe. Now trying to bring it inside, and there's going to be a shot, rolls out, will not go. Jason Spurgeon will secure the rebound for BG. Marcus Hill bringing up the pace, do a jump step inside, little jumper from about 8 feet will not go, and Smith will secure the rebound for Buffalo. Ryan Sable with the ball, kicks it to Adams. And Chapman's going to get that one and throw it right to Jason Spurgeon. Not sure he was trying to get down low there. Either way, Falcons bring up the other way. Humphrey fakes a three-pointer, drops it down inside to Agee on the left block. He'll try to swing a pass down to Spurgeon on the other side of the court. That'll be tipped out. Will stay Falcons ball. So, Holden, what are you seeing early from the Falcons in terms of what they're trying to set up on offense?
A lot of the same things from both teams, truly. It's been a pretty slow scoring affair thus far. We're only looking at 2 minutes in, but neither is getting much to go.
Trey Thomas takes a three from the right corner, will not go. Chapman on the other side for Buffalo. That's going to be a late foul call. Definitely got contact. He'll miss the layup with the left hand, and he will go to the line for two. Now this is going to be something to watch. That'll be a foul on Rashawn Agee. Rashawn Agee has had foul trouble recently. At least 4 personal fouls in 4 of his last 5 games and 8 times this season. Chapman at the line makes his first after bouncing around the rim a few times. And interesting here, Marcus Hill going to get a break on the bench. EJ Greer going to come in for BG. So the Falcons going with a very tall lineup. as Chapman hits his second one. Falcons only with one player on the court right now under 6 foot four, that being Trey Thomas standing at 6 foot. Thomas to Humphrey, back to Thomas at the top of the key. And he's going to throw this one right away. That's going to be picked off by Sean Faulcher, and he's going to be fouled hard down on the other end going up for a layup. We'll see who they assign the foul to. Is John Humphrey taking a second to get back up, slid back into the base of the rim. And they'll assign it to Dejon Humphrey. That'll be Humphrey's first, second team foul for the Falcons. That's going to send Sean Faulcher to the line for two. Faulcher misses the first one, too strong off the back rim. And very early on now, Holden, two fouls and two turnovers for the Falcons. Buffalo's turned over just once, very early in this one, but interesting to see that so far.
Yeah, as far as what we've talked about, not what you'd like to see for the Falcons.
As Faulcher splits the pair at the line, Bowling Green pushing the pace on the other end. They're going to slow it down. E.J. Greer with it on the right wing. He'll pass it back to Marcus Hill back on the court. Greer down low to A.G. outside to Humphrey. Humphrey pulls the three, too strong off the back rim, but Jason Spurgeon with the offensive rebound. Spurgeon goes up strong with the right hand. Rebounded, though, on the miss. Rashawn A.G. powers a two-hand slam in.
Perfect position there to catch the rebound off of, catch the pass from Spurgeon's attempt. And
basically a pass from Spurgeon, not sure it was meant to be. Went off the front of the rim, though, right into the hands of A.G., perfectly placed. There's now a miscommunication down low. Janivius Smith had no one in front of him. He'll answer A.G. with a two-hand slam of his own. Early on, Buffalo up 5-4 after 3 minutes of action. 16:54 and counting in the Stroh Center. Marcus Hill working around a Jason Spurgeon screen on the right wing. Now an A.G. screen. He'll pass it out to Humphrey. Humphrey drives in and he's going to run into his own man. Rashawn A.G. stumbled backwards, and that'll be a travel call. The third turnover early on for this Falcons team.
And if you're the Bulls, obviously it's very early in the game. That's exactly the kind of start you'd like to see Bowling Green having. They're making the kinds of mistakes that you need to be able to take advantage of to win this kind of game, and so far they have been.
This is a Falcons team averaging 80 points per game during MAC play so far. Right now just four to show for it after 3.5 minutes. As here's going to be a turnover by Buffalo. Chapman couldn't handle it down low. Humphrey pushing the pace the other way. Right-handed layup falls. Falcons back ahead 6-5 early on. And yet another turnover for Buffalo right away. That's going to be called an offensive foul on the Bulls. It'll be assigned to Isaiah Adams. That was a quick, about 5 second possession there for Buffalo.
And that's something we talked about in the pregame. Buffalo has a significant turnover problem, and already in this early game, we can see that affecting them negatively.
Didn't show right away, but it's definitely showed now. Both teams with three turnovers early on. Marcus Hill jump step inside, almost lost it. Kicks it back out to Thomas at the BG logo midcourt. And he's going to drop it down to Jason Spurgeon. In the fourth turnover of the game for the Falcons, as Spurgeon walked trying to get inside for a shot. Very sloppy start to this one. If you're just tuning in, Falcons up 6-5 on the Buffalo Bulls, 4 minutes into this one. Ryan Sable passes it to Smith. Smith gonna drive inside. That's gonna be stripped away by Dejon Humphrey. Humphrey down the other end. He'll put up the layup. Will not go. Missed opportunity there by the Falcons to add on to this early lead in transition. Buffalo gets the ball right back. Ryan Sable passing off to Janivius Smith once again. Now to Faulcher. Faulcher being pressured to midcourt. He'll drop it off to Lloyd McVay. Just checked in. Out to Chapman, and he'll make a little jumper. Mid-range jumper on the left wing. Buffalo back ahead, 7-6. Now Marcus Hill for the Falcons throws this one out. Over to John Humphrey, right wing. Back to Trey Thomas at the top. Down low to AG, working inside. He'll try to put up a fadeaway jumper. Will not go. So now we're going to have PJ Edwards checking in for the Falcons at the next dead ball. And this one will go for Buffalo now. So there's a mid-range jumper by Sean Faulcher. Buffalo extending the lead now up to 3. Down low to AG once again. Inside, cutting Jason Spurgeon. And the 7-footer from Australia hammers it down with 2 hands. Faulcher bringing it up the court for Buffalo, guarded by Trey Thomas. Down low to Chapman. Chapman pulls a shot over Spurgeon, will not go. Rebound secured by Marcus Hill, had to pass it off so it didn't travel. Fell down after gaining the rebound. Either way, Trey Thomas with it back to Hill. Hill drive down to his left side, go up strong, misses the layup, but it's called a foul on Jonavia Smith, as that's going to take us to our first media timeout. 13:57 to go in the first half of this one. Buffalo maintains a 1-point lead over the Falcons, 9-8. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Terrible, but Buffalo up with a 9-8 lead here after 6 minutes of play at the Stroh Center. Joined by my partner Holden Rock, I'm Tyler Kavlitz. And Holden, what stuck out to you so far in this one that's allowed Buffalo to get the early advantage?
Well, calling a spade, we talked about in the pregame that in a large amount of the statistical categories, Bowling Green has the advantage coming into tonight. And in almost all of those, they've been the worst team tonight so far. So Buffalo is just not making some of the same textbook mistakes they've made all season, and Bowling Green is, and it's showing in the game being close right now.
Marcus Hill at the line for the Falcons. Misses the first one. Hill last game against Central Michigan played 43 minutes, 22-7-7. He did only go 5-for-9 from the line. Shoot 73.5% from there on the season. This one hits front rim but gets a friendly home court rule. He'll split a pair from the line, 9-9 game here at the Stroh Center. Buffalo swinging this one around the outside, finds the hands of Isaiah Adams. Adams working on Humphrey down to the left low block. Adams spins around, puts up a lefty floater, that'll go. Buffalo, the first one to crack double digits here tonight. Trey Thomas bringing up the court for the Falcons. He'll pass off to Marcus Hill. He'll reset at the midcourt logo. Hill now driving into his left side. Puts up a right-handed little finger roll. And that one will fall. Nice layup there by Marcus Hill. Faulcher with it on the other end for Buffalo. And there's the mistake that you're talking about, Holden. threw that one away to basically no one. Marcus Hill tried to get it, though, but stepped out of bounds. So Falcons, a little missed opportunity there to capitalize on a possible turnover. Instead, it's going to be a turnover for the Falcons.
And certainly a nice break from the Bulls, for the Bulls, excuse me, who, you know, have done that several times this game, and I'm sure we'll do it again.
That's the second or third time we've seen the miscommunication on passes. It's thrown into Ryan Sable, the freshman guard. Sable will kick it out to Chapman. He'll pull a three, will not go. Jason Spurgeon secures the rebounds for the Orange and Brown. Off the Hill. Hill pushing the pace. Back out to Spurgeon. Kicked around to Humphrey. Back to Spurgeon. Spurgeon surveys. Almost gets knocked out of his hands. He'll give it back to Thomas. He'll reset with 12 on the shot clock. Thomas off a P.J. Edwards pick. Drops it off down low to Spurgeon. Spurgeon gets up the layup with the left hand, and that goes. Jason Spurgeon now with 4 points on 2-for-3 shootings and 3 rebounds here early. Isaiah Adams with it on the left low block. Once again, gets the jumper. This one will not go. Marcus Hill gets the rebound for the Falcons. Hill once again pushing the pace down to the left side, down to the rim, gets it up, and after a few bounces on that rim, it goes. Back-to-back buckets for BG. 15-11, Falcons leading, just under 12 minutes to go here in the Stroh Center. Chapman down low working on P.J. Edwards. He gets it up, will not go. The putback attempt by Lloyd McVay also will not go. Kind of feel the momentum starting to slide over to BG's side. Now P.J. Edwards finds himself open in the right corner. Cannot knock down the triple. P.J. Edwards now has missed 15 straight three-pointers. Something hasn't been great for him. Isaiah Adams with it around the wing. It's going to be kicked around a few times. Chapman misses the three-pointer off the left corner. Falcons secure the rebound. Trey Thomas off to Edwards. Back to Thomas. Humphrey going to step into a three. Dejon Humphrey too strong off the back rim. Rebounded by Buffalo. Ryan Sable bringing it up for the Bulls. Going to try to work around the pick. Trey Thomas sticks with him nicely. He'll drive down to the right side, kick it out to Isaiah Adams. He'll pull the three. That one will not go either. We're starting to see this Buffalo team really lean into that three-point shooting.
And Tyler, what you said about the momentum is pretty clear to see too. 15-11, a four-point margin, though not large, is the largest of this game so far. And we've just watched a sequence of Buffalo missing several shots back-to-back-to-back, as well as miscommunications. And it's already starting to seem to change into a bit of a different game.
That one slid out of bounds after the miss. That takes us to our second media timeout here tonight. 10:41 to go in the first half. Bowling Green up 15-11 on Buffalo. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball on Falcon Radio.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
15-11 on the Buffalo Bulls. 10:41 to go in this first half. And Holden, we are talking off the air. It's not too much action so far. Neither team hit a three-pointer yet. Falcons 0-4, Bulls 0-3.
No, several attempts, but they just can't get them to fall, and it's been kind of a game of error so far.
There's yet another missed one. Trey Thomas in the left corner doesn't get it to go. Falcons now 0-5 from deep. Sable bringing it up for the Bulls. Passing off to Isaiah Adams on the left wing. Adams trying to work inside around P.J. Edwards. He'll dump it off to Smith outside to Sable, and there's the first three-pointer of the game. Ryan Sable gets it to go for Buffalo. Falcons now the other way. Pass off to E.J. Greer, back to Marcus Hill. Over to Trey Thomas on the left wing. Thomas has to pick up his dribble, drops it off to P.J. Edwards. P.J. Edwards working inside, puts up the right layup, does not go, but an offensive rebound and two-handed slam by Rashawn Agee. Rashawn Agee has the most offensive rebounds since the start of MAC play for a reason. And he finished that one with authority. Now on the other end, Sean Faulcher for Buffalo. Spin move, tries to get a pass down low to Smith. That one's going to go out of bounds, but it'll be off the Falcons. Bulls will retain possession. Cy Chapman will check back in. Ryan Sable will check out. Chapman gets the ball off the inbound, working inside. He'll kick it out. Thrown around a few times. A three-pointer pulled by Bryson Wilson, and that one will fall. Bryson Wilson's first shot attempt of the game is good, and it's for three. We're tied 17 apiece. Now A.J. down low once again off a pass from E.J. Greer. This one slammed with the right hand only. But the Falcons back ahead 19-17. A.J. with two emphatic slams back to back.
And the Bulls are really just having a hard time doing anything to defend him down low.
Cy Chapman with it for Buffalo. Kicked around a few times once again. Faulcher with it, gonna throw it cross court to Adams. He almost stepped out. He'll pull into a three. This one rims out. Real close to back to back to back. Three-pointers for Buffalo. Because now AG's gonna try to spin move, get a right-handed shot off. That one will not go. Falcons starting to lean into their faster paced offense on the offensive side. So now Jason Spurge is going to check in for BG. PJ Edwards will check out. On the court now for the Falcons, Marcus Hill, Rashawn Agee, DeJon Humphrey, Jason Spurge, and EJ Greer. So now Buffalo, that's going to be a quick run by Faulcher there, and he'll get that layup in. Very quick possession for Buffalo, tied up again right now, 19-19. 8 minutes to play here in the first half. Marcus Hill with the ball for the Falcons. Hill passes it out to Humphrey. Humphrey looking for something to Greer inside to Agee. Agee working inside, kicks out to Jason Spurge in the right corner. That one's going to be short, will not go. Falcons still really struggling from deep, not able to get a three-pointer to go yet off six attempts. Smith is going to fake one here. Agee bites it. He'll spin around him, but he doesn't have anywhere to go with it. He'll try to pass it out to Bryson Wilson. He's losing the ball, keeps it in bounds. EJ Greer fell down. It's kicked out to the right side. Buffalo has to get a shot off with the shot clock about the sound. That one will not go. Genevieve Smith on the shot. Agee working inside, quick for the Falcons, off to Spurgeon, outside to Humphrey, back into Agee, and yet another one-handed slam by Rashawn Agee.
And Rashawn Agee in this early game is really just putting on a show here, now leading the Falcons in points and rebounds, really getting it done on both ends of the court.
Agee continuing to be dominant like he's been so far through MAC play. Now we're going to have a travel called on Cy Chapman on the other side. Ran over Dejon Humphrey. Going to get called for the shuffling of the feet. Falcons up 21-19, 6:38 to go in the first half. We're going to take a break as they take a break on the court. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
Hey, I'm Lucas Kleinmeier, and you are listening to a presentation of the Falcon Media Sports Network on Falcon Radio. For Falcons, by Falcons.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
When someone hears the words, "You have cancer," it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
Back here at the Stroh Center, coming out of the third media timeout of the first half, Falcons leading the Bulls 21-19, 6:38 to go in the first half. Joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Kavlitz. And Holden, what have been your takeaways so far as we're nearing the end of this first half?
Well, it's been a pretty similar game from both sides, but in particular the Bulls in the later minutes of this half have started to do the things we expected. They're attempting their threes, they're turning over the ball quite a bit, but just towards the end of, before we took a timeout there, they made two threes, and that's kept it close.
And Bowling Green, 10 for 22 from the field, not a bad mark. They haven't got a three to go, though. What do you want to see from them on offense?
You'd like to see some better looks from outside the arc, frankly. Going 0 for 6 is just not anything you want to see ever, really.
Marcus Hill tries to get a pass into Sean Agee. It's going to be knocked out of bounds, but it'll be called a kicked ball. Possession will stay with the Orange and Brown. Sean Humphrey will inbound. To Trey Thomas, left wing, down low to Agee. Agee swings it out to Jason Spurge in the right corner. He will nail this one. Jason Spurgeon hits the three, puts the Falcons lead up to five.
Just like we said, finally getting a three for the Falcons. And I'm sure they'll look to build on that more.
And Agee really just drawing all the attention right now when he goes inside that paint area. Isaiah Adams going to kick it out to Ryan Sable, and he'll respond with a three-pointer of his own. Back-to-back three-pointers here inside the Stroh Center. Trey Thomas with the ball, passing off to Dejon Humphrey. Back to Thomas, top of the key for the Falcons. Off to Marcus Hill on the left side, across the court to Humphrey. Humphrey will drive in, float with his right hand, will not go. Dejon Agee almost secured that offensive rebound, did not get it. Appears to be holding his right hand. We'll see if anything comes out of that. Kick to the outside once again. Lloyd McVay misses that one for Buffalo, but they maintain possession off the offensive rebound. And this one's going to be swung inside to Chapman off the pass from Jonavius Smith. And Chapman going to hammer that home with authority. Back to a tie game after the Falcons had the five-point lead, 24-24, 5 minutes to play in the first half. Marcus Hill drives in, left side, puts up a right-handed layup, will not go. Rebound by Lloyd McVay and Buffalo. A Isaiah Adams going to drive in with the left hand. Will not go. Falcons going to get the rebound. And I believe there's going to be a foul call on Jonivius Smith. It will be a foul call on Jonivius Smith after Jahna Humphrey got that rebound. That's an interesting one. Appeared to hit him as he was gaining the rebound. Referees said he had possession of the ball. Tack on a foul for Buffalo. So Holden Falcons getting leads, but they're not being able to hold them right now. Buffalo keeps fighting back. What do you want to see from the Falcons to start getting out ahead a little more?
Well, with the Falcons, you just want to see more consistency in capitalizing on the possessions that you have, not throwing them away, and making the shots when you take them.
Because now we're going to have a tech called off the bench of Buffalo. I believe that's Jonivius Smith. It will be Jonivius Smith sitting on the bench. It must have been something he said to the officials there, guys. Attention, that's going to be a tech by them. Marcus Hill will take the free throw. Excuse me, Trey Thomas will take the free throw for the Falcons. Thomas, 80% from the line on the season. Hell drain that one. And Thomas will hit both.
Smith talking to his coach on the bench. If you're Buffalo and you look at the things you've done this season and the keys to your success, a technical off of the bench is certainly the last thing you want to see.
Definitely is.
Odd one there.
And Smith, if you remember, just had that foul called on him, disagreed with it, thought that BG did not have the possession yet. Thought it was just contact trying to gain a rebound.
Clearly frustrated.
Yeah, gets the tech call right after. Back to action, Marcus Hill with it, kicks it outside to Jason Spurgeon. Around the arc to E.J. Greer, inside to A.G. right block, down to a cutting Thomas, and he's going to throw this one away to Isaiah Adams. Adams pushing the pace for Buffalo. He'll put up a left-handed layup. That will fall. Buffalo ties the game yet again. Trey Thomas with the ball for the Falcons. Slows it down and surveys. Hill passing off the Greer around the horn to Jason Spurgeon. Spurgeon inside to A.G. Back outside to Greer. He's going to drive in and kick it up Thomas. Thomas over to Spurgeon. He's going to pull a deep three-pointer. Will not go off the rim. Rebounded by Cy Chapman and the Bulls. Ryan Sable with it. He's just going to throw that one away off pressure by Jason Spurgeon. Trey Thomas with it. Kicks it out to Spurgeon. Left corner. Will not go. But an offensive rebound by Rashawn Agee. However, he's going to lose his footing, fall backwards. He's going to be caught for the travel. AG will take a second to get up. But we have reached the final media timeout of the first half. Tied 26-26 here inside the Stroh Center. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
When someone hears the words, you have cancer, it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Astro Center. 3:31 to play in the first half. Bowling Green 26, Buffalo 26. Joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Cavillitz. And Holden, right now, would you say it's more of Bowling Green not being able to get started, or Buffalo playing above expectations?
I think it's a mixture of both, but I would largely attribute it to Bowling Green not really being able to get started. We're not seeing any of like the strengths of the team that they've shown all year coming out. And again, as we talked about, they're putting up similar or in some cases inferior numbers kind of across the board.
Falcons shot just 32.9% from the field and shade over 21% on threes last game against Central Michigan. Right now, 40% from the field and 11% on three-pointers. They got just one triple to fall. Because now we're going to have a foul call on Marcus Hill as Isaiah Adams fell. Hill and the entire Bowling Green bench do not agree with that call. That'll be Hill's first personal foul of the game. Falcons third. Inbound pass here by Adams, going to be picked off. Jason Spurgeon comes away with it. Pass to Hill. He'll bring it up for the Falcons. Screen set by A.J. Hill goes around to the right side. Driving into the paint, he'll go back out. Pass out to Thomas, right wing. Thomas out to Spurgeon, around to Greer. Back to Hill. He'll pull the mid-ranger, will not go. Hard contact. Rebound by Chapman. Ran into Jason Spurgeon midair. Spurgeon went down. He gets back up, and it'll be Buffalo ball. I think we're going to have a foul called there. I'm not sure who they assigned it to. We will get that to you once we get it. Trey Thomas is going to be assigned with that. Interesting. Isaiah Adams with the ball for Buffalo off the Chapman. Now to Fulcher. Fulcher puts up the shot. Will not go. Rebounded by Jason Spurgeon and the Orange and Brown. Pushed ahead to Greer off to Thomas. Thomas back to Greer, left wing. Greer back to Thomas. Game of hot potato right now, outside the arc for the Falcons. Thomas drives in, back out to Spurgeon. Spurgeon back to Thomas. 8 on the shot clock, back to Greer. Greer drives inside, gets the right hand of the layup to go up off the backboard. A little too strong off the front rim, will not go for the Falcons. Isaiah Adams, a deep two, pulled up, foot in the line. That one a little strong also. Trey Thomas pushing the pace for the Falcons. He'll get a shot up. Little fadeaway jumper will not go, but he will get fouled. Go to the line for two. Thomas already 2 for 2 from the line. Took those two tacks after Janivia Smith was called for the tack sitting on the bench.
And for the Bulls, that's something they would certainly hate to see. When one of your strengths as a team is being the best in the conference in not giving fouls when you don't need to, it's just a mental error.
A rare miss by Trey Thomas. Just his 7th missed free throw of the season on 33 attempts so far. Thomas came into the game as 80% from the charity stripe. He'll split a pair. Falcons get the lead once again, 27-26. Under 2 minutes to play here at the Stroh Center in the first half of this one. It's going to be Ryan Sable bringing the ball up for the Bulls. Passed off to Adams. Adams around to Chapman. Chapman drives in, right-handed layup does not go. Jason Spurgeon stood tall, forced the miss. Rebound secured by A.G. A.G. pushed it ahead to Marcus Hill. Marcus Hill lost the ball, regains it. Off to an open Jason Spurgeon, left corner. That three-pointer goes, and it's going to force Buffalo to take the timeout. Bowling Green up 30-26 after the Jason Spurgeon three. 1:16 to go in the first half. We'll take a break with them on the court. You're listening to BJSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now
ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Welcome back into the Stroh Center. 1:16 to play in the first half of this Tuesday night action contest. Joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Kavlitz, and Holden, you can feel the momentum once again starting to shift to the Falcons' side now. They've gained, they've built a four-point lead over Buffalo, looking to build on it with the last minute remaining in this half.
And looking at the kind of team that the Falcons have been in the second half of games this year, this is exactly the kind of tone that you want to set going into halftime.
Zay Adams going to pull a mid-ranger from the left wing, a little too strong. Falcons will secure the rebound. Hill going to bring it up. Right-handed little floater layup will not go. Offensive rebound by Jason Spurgeon. Spurgeon gets it up, will not go. Buffalo will secure the rebound. Ryan Sable, he'll bring it up for the Bulls. Kicks it out to Chapman. Chapman drives in from the left wing over to Sable on the right wing. Sable with it. Passes it around to Chapman on the outside over to Fulcher. Fulcher around E.J. Greer, blocked by A.G. inside. Falcons pushing it up fast-paced. Trey Thomas puts the layup, will not go. Are we going to have a goaltender or a foul here? I believe it's going to be called a goaltend. Looks like one of the Bulls got their hand up into the rim and hit it. That will be a bucket for BG. Now this is kind of odd. The inbound by Buffalo is going to be called back. They're going to have to redo it. Can't remember the last time I saw that. 17.1 seconds to go in the first half. Clock starts running. Buffalo down by 6, 32-26, looking to cut the deficit going into halftime. Chapman pulls the three from the outside, will not go. Rebound secured by Trey Thomas. 5 seconds. Three on the clock. Thomas to Hill inside, gets the layup up, and it goes as the buzzer sounds. Bowling Green will enter halftime up by 8, 34-26 over the Buffalo Bulls. We'll take a break for a few minutes and get back to recap the first 20 minutes of this contest. You're listening to BJC Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack, and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast. To work hard. To do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling. We have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Welcome back into the Stroh Center. Just under 10 minutes until tip-off of the second half. We're at halftime. BG up 34-26 by 8 points over the Buffalo Bulls, as we currently have a Star Wars-themed lightsaber battle halftime going on here at Star Wars Night at the Stroh Center. Joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Kavlitson. Holden, looking at the box score that we just got for the first half, what stick out to you in terms of team stats, player stats?
Well, in keeping with this Star Wars team, I'd say the force is very strong with Rashawn Agee. You look at his line, he's got 7 rebounds. He's got 8 total points. Very, very close to another double-double, as he's done many times recently, and those are both very big for the team. Also of note to me is the points in the paint. BG has been dominant in the paint, scoring 24 paint points as opposed to Buffalo's 12.
Indeed they have. Halftime stats, Bowling Green, 41.2% from the field, 2 for 10 from beyond the arc, just shooting 20% of three-pointers, 4 for 6 from the line. On the other side, Buffalo 34.5% from the field. They're 3 for 10 from deep and 3 for 4 from the line. You look at the rebounding marks, Falcons up by 5 in that category right now, 22-17. And like you talked about it, Rashawn Agee, very close to a double-double already. His 11th double-double would be in the past 15 games. He right now has 8 points with 7 rebounds, 3 of those coming on the offensive side. That puts him up to 80 offensive rebounds here so far in this season. Then you look down, Jason Spurgeon has been a good surprise for the Falcons scoring-wise this one. They haven't really had him inside too much. They've had him positioned around that arc as a 7-footer that you have to guard that is a 3-point threat. 10 points, 5 rebounds for the big man right now. And Marcus Hill, 9 points, rounding out the top scorers for the Falcons. Over on Buffalo side, Cy Chapman and Ryan Sable are the leading scorers, each with 6. Sable's 2-for-2 from the field, both of them 3-pointers. Meanwhile, Chapman has not hit a 3-on-3 attempts, just 2-for-8 from the field. And something interesting to look at again is Falcons haven't had a bench point yet. So they've struggled with depth recently. P.J. Edwards has played 5 minutes off the bench. E.J. Greer, 10 minutes. That's all the contributions they've got a minute-wise off the bench. Neither of them have got a point on 3 shots. So are you concerned with that lack of contribution from the bench, Golden, or is that something that you think we'll see more in the second half?
I think in the second half, you'll definitely be inclined to see more bench contributions just as the game progresses and guys need to take breaks. But at the same time, it can definitely be concerning because you can't always lean on your starting five to carry the entire game for the team. So I would like to see for the Falcons some more contributions from the bench in the second half, but I'm just not sure that we're on like concern watch yet.
What do you think for Buffalo? You look at, we talked about them, A.J. Spurgeon Hill. They've been very good for the Falcons here tonight, those three. Specifically A.J. just in every facet of the game. If you're Buffalo, what are you game planning right now here in the locker rooms at halftime to try to stop those three, and specifically Rashawn A.J.?
Well, I think you have to look at what A.J.'s doing. As we already talked about, he's obviously a threat to score and a threat to get the rebounds and help distribute to his teammates to get second chance points. And to that avail, you have to do your best to defend him without finding yourself out of position and scrambling to then catch up to whichever other player for the Falcons he may pass out to, or getting burned in the paint by him, which they have in the first half so far. And that's no simple task against a player like Rashawn A.J., but they're going to have to limit his contributions in every regard.
And then if you're looking at BG's side, I don't think there's too much to complain about on that defensive side. What on offense do you think they get to get going a little more? They're only 34 points. That's not terrible, but that's a little below what they've been averaging here during MAC play. What do you want to see from them to get this offense a little more kickstarted?
Like you said, they're behind pace for their average, and I think a large part of it is just some of the shot selection that they had. You know, they've had some turnovers, but nothing outlandish by comparatively in this game. I think a lot of it comes down to the types of shots they're taking. And so if they can clean that up, I think they will look to improve that in the second half, which would be a very much a trademark of this team as we've seen this year.
The Falcons, when leading at halftime, are 10-1. Buffalo, when showing at halftime, is 0-17. 5 minutes to go until tip-off. We'll take a break, get back to you for that second half tip-off. We'll see if those numbers stay true. Bowling Green leading at halftime, 34-26 over Buffalo. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack, and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Whoa! Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast. To work hard. To do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling. We have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
When someone hears the words, "You have cancer," it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
Just under 40 seconds away from tip-off of the second half here at the Stroh Center. Falcons leading the Buffalo Bulls 34-26 here at halftime. Joined by my partner, Holden Ruck. I'm Tyler Kavlitz. And Holden, we talked about it a little bit at halftime, but coming right out of the gates, we know Bowling Green's been a really good second half team this season. What do you want to see from them offensively and defensively to really solidify this lead and even expand it?
Well, in particular, what I'd like to see the most is more of an offensive explosion. When you look at the year, they've scored 910 points in the second half as opposed to 744 on the year in the first half, which is a pretty noticeable difference. And I think to that avail, they should be extending their lead out of the gate early, getting some stops, but really like making sure that their own possessions are resulting in points. I think that's the key for them to put this one away in the second half.
And for Buffalo, what do you want to see on their side if they want to cut this 8-point deficit and then possibly come away with an upset win here at the Stroh Center?
Well, if you're Buffalo, things have not been working for you for like several games in a row. And so to that extent, you need to break away from some of the things that have been killing you. You can't be committing as many turnovers as you are, and you can't be missing all those 3-point attempts.
Buffalo has won 3 straight against the Falcons. Last BG win against Buffalo at the Stroh Center came late 2020. Buffalo will start the ball in the second half. Ryan Sable. Going to be passed off a few times down inside to Smith. And Smith is going to give it away. This is Smith's first action, I believe, since he was called for that tech on the bench. He was sat down for the rest of that half, and on his first possession back on the court, gives it away to the Falcons.
Not what he'd like to have.
Trey Thomas with the ball for BG. Passes off to Spurgeon. Back to Thomas on the left wing. Back to Spurgeon. Across the right wing to DeJon Humphrey, back to Thomas. Hot potato going on. Ball's passed back to Humphrey, now down low to Agee. AG with seven on the shot clock, puts up a left-handed floater, and that one goes for Rashawn AG. You can mark Rashawn AG into double-digit points with 10.
And AG just making his presence felt out of the gate again. And we talked about that's one of the things Buffalo is going to have to limit if they're going to be able to stay competitive in this, and so far that has not happened.
We talked about that at halftime. Doesn't look like they figured that out coming out of the half. Ryan Sable going to pull a three-pointer for Buffalo. No good. Offensive rebound by Janavius Smith, though. Outside, another three-point attempt. Will not go. Another offensive rebound by Buffalo. And Sable is going to try it once again from the right corner. Third time's the charm. Ryan Sable gets it. The drop for Buffalo. 36-29, BG's lead. Trey Thomas swings it over to Marcus Hill. Back to Thomas. He's going to try to drive inside to the left, but he's going to be stopped. However, there will be a blocking foul called on Ryan Sable. Sable played last season at Gonzaga College High School. It's going to be his first personal foul of the game. Down inside to Rashawn Agee, but this time Rashawn Agee is stopped by Cy Chapman. However, Chapman will get called for the foul. AG was looking for his fourth emphatic dunk of the game.
And frankly, for the Bulls, that might be one of the only ways to limit his points because he's been just so dominant in the paint so far. Gets that one to miss. But
and it's really interesting watching how they use Chapman. He's 6'8", 227, but they really keep him on the outside of the arc for most of these offensive possessions, which is pretty interesting.
It is curious, very somewhat unorthodox for a guy of his stature, but
especially, he only shoots 27% from deep, so it's very interesting that they do that. At the line, AG hits the first one and hits the second one, makes both. Falcons up to a 9-point lead, 38-29. 2 minutes gone by here in the second half. Isaiah Adams is looking to pull it for Buffalo, will not. Chapman on the right wing with it. Back up top to Sean Faulcher. Back over to Chapman. Chapman working on Spurgeon. Down low, goes up strong and gets the layup to go. Now on the other end is Jean Humphrey working inside. Marcus Hill working inside. Puts the shot, will not go. Rashawn Agee with yet another offensive rebound. Can't contain it. It falls out. Jason Spurgeon slides on the floor about 2 feet trying to grab it and just hits the out-of-bounds area. Falcons will give it away. And I feel like there's been those little mistakes by BG where they've had chances to extend this lead and really pull away, and they just haven't been able to capitalize on all those opportunities yet.
And where we can see them up by seven right now, those kinds of mistakes are what's keeping Buffalo in the ballgame right now.
Down low, Smith with it. He'll kick it out to Isaiah Adams. Adams will pull a three, no good. Humphrey at the rebound. He's going to push pace for the Falcons. To Trey Thomas. Thomas working inside. Goes up strong. Will not go. AG trying to secure the offensive rebound, but he will touch it last. It will be Buffalo ball. Buffalo still looking to form some form of offensive identity in this one. Haven't really found it yet. Faulcher with the ball over to Isaiah Adams on the right wing. Down low to Chapman now on the right block. Guarded by Spurgeon. Going to be a double team by Thomas. Thomas almost comes away with it. Finds Ryan Sable in the left corner wide open. Sable does not get it to go, but an offensive rebound by Smith. Down low, Chapman once again off to Janavia Smith. Out to the corner, left corner once again. Ryan Sable missed the first, hit the second.
It's something the Bulls have capitalized on so far in this young second half is taking advantage of second opportunities. They've had several possessions where they've been able to get points off of the second chance with five so far.
Sable came in the game 10th in the MAC and three-pointers made with 38. He's 4-for-6 from deep here tonight. Falcons going to turn this one over. Miscommunication. Isaiah Adams down low. He'll kick it out. It'll be passed around a little bit. Faulcher with it now. Working on Spurgeon, a mismatch for Buffalo. He's going to work inside, get a layup. Right-handed, it will fall. The mismatch on Spurgeon, scooted right past him. Got an open look and drained it. And now Buffalo has cut this once 9-point Falcon lead down to 2. 38-36 with just under 16 minutes to play here in the second half. Marcus Hill gets an open lane, the left side, puts it up with the right hand, and it goes. It's now Buffalo. Sean Faucher bringing up the court. He'll step back, be wide open for a three. Rims out, though. Rashawn Agee secures the rebound. He's now one short of a double-double. Marcus Hill working on Sable. He'll hit a fadeaway shot. Four straight points by Marcus Hill. He's starting to heat up. Chalk Hill in for 13 points on 6-for-11 shooting. Now Chapman turns it over for Buffalo. Trey Thomas pickpocketed it, and he's going to throw this one away. Slip through the hands of Rashawn Agee. Faucher pushing the pace for Buffalo. Passes it inside to Chapman a little high. He'll secure it, though, and hit the layup. 42-38 the score, under 15 minutes to play. Trey Thomas slowing things down for the Falcons, the floor general of this BG team surveys. Thomas whips it around to Marcus Hill. Marcus Hill, a little jumper just inside the free throw line. 6 straight points for Marcus Hill. The Mac's leading scorer is starting to heat up. So now Buffalo will also slow their offense down. Swing over to Chapman, tried to get it into Nivea Smith, lost it, got it back. Isaiah Adams gonna pull a three-pointer on the left side, and that'll fall. So now Buffalo starting to find a rhythm a little bit from deep. 6-for-18 from beyond the arc now. And just like that, Bowling Green's lead's cut down once again, holding 44-41. And before we can even say anything else, Marcus Hill hits yet another jumper inside the free throw line.
And despite re-extending the lead there, it's pretty clear that Buffalo is starting to feel it a little bit. They're getting in rhythm with their three ball, like you said, and we know they like to shoot the three. And that'll be an interesting thing to watch as the half continues.
They definitely do like to pull the trigger on that deep shot, and they're going to do it once again. Jonavia Smith, a little strong. Trey Thomas secures the rebound for the Falcons. Marcus Hill has 8 straight points for the Orange and Brown. However, Agee's going to take it. He'll get the layup to go and the foul on the floor. He'll get a chance for a three-point opportunity. However, before he can do that, we're going to take a media timeout. 13-17 to go in the first half. 48-41, Bowling Green leads the Buffalo Bulls. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
When someone hears the words, "You have cancer," it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
The Stroh Center, 13-17 to go in the first half. Joined by my partner Holden Rock, I'm Tyler Kavlitz. And Holden, Buffalo had cut the BG lead down to 2. And then Marcus Hill decided to score 8 straight for the Falcons. Buffalo got some shots in between that run. However, right before we went to break, Sean Agee got a shot to go, and he got fouled on it. He'll take a free throw as we come back right here. And Marcus Hill really just starting to take over this game, the max leading scorer doing what he does.
He did, and when you look at the Falcons, it's the two guys that we've looked to all year and that we're looking to again tonight as being real difference makers in the game so far as we've seen it. Rashawn Agee and Marcus Hill both doing exactly what they've been doing all year, playing their strengths, and it's showing up in the result right now.
Marcus Hill with 17 points and 8 for 13 shooting, a very efficient night. He has seven straight 20-plus point performances, the longest active streak in the nation and the third longest this season. 3 points away from extending that to 8 contests in a row. Rashawn Agee, the Chicago, Illinois native at the line, hits the free throw. Mark Agee up to 15 points and 9 rebounds, one board shy of another double-double. Would be his 11th in the past 15 games. Isaiah Adams with the ball for the Bulls. Adams looking on the outside. He'll pass this one off to McVay. Now over to Faulcher. Faulcher working inside on Trey Thomas. He'll kick this one out to Sable. Sable fakes the three-pointer, drives inside, gets shot out over Greer before the shot clock goes off, and BG secures the rebound. Don't know what that stoppage was for. I believe they assigned a foul to someone. I did not hear who it was. We'll get that to you once we see that come through. In the meantime, Trey Thomas brings the ball up for the Falcons. Thomas kicks off the hill in the corner to Greer. Greer pulls the trigger on the three-pointer, will not go. Buffalo secures the rebound before it goes out of bounds. Sable bringing it up for the Bulls. Off to Chapman, side Chapman with the ball for Buffalo, kicks it out to Faulcher. Faulcher on the left wing, moves to the top of the arc, gets a pass into Adams to the corner to Sable, that will not go. Excuse me, that was McVay who pulled the triple, not Sable. Either way, Marcus Hill, a little jump shot. Hill drains that. Mark him up to 19 on the game. And the Falcons have the biggest lead of the game so far. 10-point advantage, 51-41, under 12 minutes to play.
The scoring of Hill in the second half has very clearly been a difference between the two teams. He was a little quieter in the first, but now it's been all Marcus Hill in this last few minutes.
He has gone into full attack mode. Isaiah Adams kicks it out. This is Ryan Sable, and he nails that one. That's the fifth three-pointer of the game for Sable.
And that's a positioning that the Bulls have caught the Falcons on several times tonight, where Sable's outside of the arc, wide open, takes the three, and more often than not, he's getting them to go.
And Sable now ties his season high for three-pointers made. He made 5 against Central Michigan on the 2nd of January. And now Rashawn Agee inside gets the layup to go, and another and-one opportunity for the big man. However, before he can shoot this layup, we've reached the second media timeout of the second half. BG up 53-44. They'll have a chance to extend it by a point when we come back. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
Minutes, 17 seconds to go in this contest. Bowling Green up 53-44 over the University at Buffalo Bulls. Joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Kavlitz, and Holden, Marcus Hill has just taken over this game. The max leading scorer up to 19 points in this one, 1 point shy of his eighth straight 20-point performance.
He has, and like you said, he's the max leading scorer for a reason, and when Bowling Green needs a guy to be a difference maker so many times this season, and again tonight, it's him stepping up, and we can see the difference in the scoreboard right now as the Falcons lead by 9.
Hill, the max leading scorer, averaging 21.3 points per game. That's tied for 11th in the nation. He's actually tied with North Carolina's R.J. Davis in that category. Rashawn Agee at the line, trying to finish off a three-point play. Push this Falcons lead back up to double digits. AG hits the free throw. Falcons up by 10, 54-44. And AG will exit stage left right after that free throw. Jason Spurgeon checking in for him. Fulcher bringing the ball up for the Bulls. Pass off to Chapman. Chapman off to Adams. Drives in the left side, working on Humphrey. Humphrey trying to get that ball away. There's going to be a foul called. I believe it will go on Dijon. It will go on Humphrey. That will be Humphrey's second foul of the game. Now inside, Lloyd McVay misses the shot. Falcons secure the rebound. The freshman E.J. Greer bringing the ball for the Orange Brown. Inside to Jason Spurgeon. Slams it home with two hands. Spurgeon been a big force for the Falcons here tonight. 12 points in the contest. Adams has this one stripped by Humphrey. Marcus Hill pushing the pace off to Greer. Greer puts the layup up and good. Falcons now up by 14. 58-44, 10.5 to play. Inside Fulcher, shot does not go. Rebound by Edwards. PJ Edwards, the UCF transfer, pushing the ball up. He'll pass it out to Greer. EJ Greer from the right corner hits the triple. EJ Greer with 5 straight points has put the Falcons up 61-44 and forced a timeout by the Buffalo Bulls.
And you can really feel inside the Stroh right now, the momentum is totally shifted in favor of the Falcons. Those 5 straight points have been a big difference maker here, and it seems like the Bulls are doing everything they can to just try and hang in there at this point.
We'll see if they'll be able to. We're going to take a break with them as they take a break on the court. 61-44, the Falcons advantage, 10-11 to go in the contest. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
You have the right to know. The right to know about culture. The right to know about the economy. The right to know about technology and to know about sports. You have the right to know about education and politics and the weather. You have the right to know what's happening abroad and in your backyard. But above all else, you have the right to know that this right is under attack and we must work to protect it. Because in order to be free, we must be informed. Understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
Back here at the Stroh Center. Falcons have pushed the lead to 61-44, just over 10 minutes to play. And E.J. Greer hit a three-pointer before that break, forcing Buffalo to take timeout. Greer, the 6'8" freshman guard from Lansdowne, Pennsylvania. He's gotten more playing time recently, double-digit minutes in the past two games, three of the last four. He's played 14 here today, and he's had five quick points, the last 5 points for the Falcons. And now, joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Cavalis, and Holden, Falcons have really taken full advantage of this, all the momentum on their side.
They absolutely have. We said right before the last timeout that you could feel the momentum change, and it's easy to see why. They've gone on 10-0 run in the last minute 27. Over 3 minutes and 53 seconds, they've outscored the Bulls 17-3, and they've upped their efficiency in a big way. They've shot 10 out of their last 11 have been makes, and that's been a huge difference maker as we look into this last 10 minutes of the game here.
And if you look at the overall numbers, 52.1% from the field right now, that three-point percent is still lacking, but the Falcons have been very efficient from the field. They're 4-0 when they shoot 50% or more from the field. We'll see if they'll keep above that mark for the rest of this one. 10 minutes to go here at the Stroh Center. Buffalo with the ball. Isaiah Adams pulls the three from the left wing, will not go. Rebounded by Marcus Hill. Hill with his fifth rebound of the game. Had seven last game against Central Michigan. Hill spinning inside, loses his footing. Slips down, ball falls out of bounds. Hill gets up unscathed, but Buffalo now has the possession. Isaiah Adams, the 6'6" senior forward, in his second season at Buffalo, brings the ball up for the Bulls. Pass back to Adams from Sable. Adams kicks it to Sable in the right corner, and Sable hits his sixth three-pointer of the game, a season high for the freshman guard from Washington, D.C.
And Sable, a big bright spot for the Bulls today, 6-8 from three. Pretty impressive number.
And now Marcus Hill gets a layup up and good. 21 points for Hill. He extends his 20-point scoring performance streak up to 8 games. And on the other side, Sean Faulcher gets inside, gets a layup to go, and an and-one opportunity. Jason Spurgeon, the big man down low from Toowoomba, Australia, called for the foul. Hill will check out of the game. Trey Thomas will check in. Rashawn Agee will also check in, it appears. Just not yet. Faulcher at the line. 62.9% of the season. He misses that one. Spurgeon gains the rebound. PJ Edwards in the right corner with the ball, working inside. He's going to be called. There's going to be a call fouled, not on Edwards. Instead, I believe they're going to send that to Bryson Wilson. They will. That'll be on Bryson Wilson. That'll be Wilson's first foul of the game. AG now will check in for Jason Spurgeon. Some well-earned rest for Jason Spurgeon and Marcus Hill for the Falcons. John Humphrey with the ball. Right wing. Surveying, guarded by Faulcher. Pass off to Trey Thomas. Trey Thomas, a deep triple falls. The Falcons up 66-49 under 9 minutes to play here at the Stroh Center. And Faulcher loses that one. Picked up by Humphreys, pushing the pace. Over to E.J. Greer, left corner. He thought about a triple, does not shoot it. P.J. Edwards inside, tried to put down an emphatic slam. Didn't get enough of it, rim stopped him. Sable passes it off to Chapman. And we're going to have a foul called on the Falcons. It's going to be on P.J. Edwards. That'll be Edwards' first foul of the game in 10 minutes, 11 minutes of action. Sable inbounds it to Faulcher. Faulcher out to Chapman. Chapman pulls the three, does not go. Rebounded by Sable. He can't maintain possession, however. Gives it away to Falcons. Marcus Hill going to check back into the game. The freshman, E.J. Greer, will check out. And Holden, E.J. Greer, we talked about needing bench points at halftime, and E.J. Greer provided that for a short stint for the Falcons.
He did. He had a nice spurt there a few minutes back, and it's been a big part of why the momentum has shifted so heavily in the favor of the Falcons.
Trey Thomas tried another deep three. Heat check did not go. Ryan Sable going to try a heat check of his own. That does not go. Now we're going to have Bryson Wilson try to get the put back there. There's going to be a foul called, however, on the Falcons. That'll lead us into another media timeout. 66-49, the BC advantage with 7:46 to play in this contest. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio. Don't go anywhere.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling. We have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
A few years ago, Steve Faircow's lungs were failing.
I don't think I had more than a couple weeks to live.
That's when Steve received a lung transplant made possible by an organ donor. Now Steve can do things he never imagined, like climbing 94 floors to the top of a skyscraper.
I never knew that breathing could feel this good. It's an incredible gift.
What could you make possible as an organ, eye, and tissue donor? Leave behind the gift of life. Go to organdonor.gov, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Health Resources and Services Administration.
.46 to go in this one here at the Stroh Center. Falcons up 66-49 on the Buffalo Bulls. Joined by my partner Holden Ruck, I'm Tyler Kavlitz. And Holden, at this point, Buffalo's going to need a big run to get back into this one. Feels like the Falcons are just holding steady with this advantage right now.
Yeah, as we stare down the last 7:46 of this one, the deficit for the Bulls right now is at 17 points, which is equivalent to the highest that it's been all game. And they're going to have a hard time overcoming that. There's a pretty long road over these last 7 minutes if they're going to be able to make a comeback.
Buffalo shooting just 37.3% from the field in this one. They have not been an efficient shooting team this season. We're seeing it here. They're actually shooting below their season average, which is 40%, which is also last in the MAC. Before we went to media timeout, there was a foul on the Falcons that was assigned to Rashawn Agee, his second. Bryson Wilson at the line, shooting free throws. It'll be a 1-1 for Wilson. Actually, instead, it will be 2. My mistake there, Wilson missed the first. Wilson, a 40% shooter on just 5 attempts coming into this one, splits a pair at the line. Trey Thomas will bring the ball up for the Falcons, going right to left on your radio dials. Thomas picks up the dribble, passes off to Agee, back to Thomas. Thomas to P.J. Edwards, thought about pulling a triple, will not, drives down inside, left-handed layup goes. Falcons lead the largest of the game up to 18, 68-50. Ivia Smith passes off to Wilson, back to Smith. Now over to Sable. Sable to Chapman on the outside, little hot potato game for the Bulls. Outside to Chapman on the right wing. He'll pull a triple off the front iron. Will not go. Marcus Hill secures the rebound for the Falcons. That's his sixth of the game. Hill picks up the dribble out to P.J. Edwards. Edwards has missed 15 straight triples. Will not attempt one there. He's going to throw it away. Actually, Isaiah Adams will pick it up, and he'll draw the foul. Edwards going to be calling for the region.
He must need it.
Edwards will check out for the incoming Jason Spurgeon.
And the turnover there for the Bulls, very much needed. They haven't scored in over 2 minutes since their last field goal. And if they're going to have any chance of getting back in this one, now looking at the largest deficit of the day, it's going to have to come soon.
Now another foul going to be called right out of that inbound. I believe it's going to be on Trey Thomas. He's not exactly sure why he got called for it. Back-to-back quick fouls by BG. 6:41 left to play in this contest. BG up 68-50 over the Bulls. Pass inside to Janivia Smith. Wide open for the slam. Gets it to go, and we're going to have another whistle. And now we're going to have a tech call, it appears. Is that a tech on Smith? I believe Smith just got assigned his second tech of the game. And he will foul out of this one with five personal fouls. That was an odd sequence of events. George Hilkovich, the third, first-year Buffalo head coach, looking for an explanation from this officiating crew. And it appears he's not happy with the one that he's received.
Certainly the kind of reaction you'd expect to see from a coach watching a player foul out of the game in that way. We were scratching our heads earlier at the technical, and once again, just kind of an odd situation.
And the officiating crew having to explain this to the PA announcer. Everyone in the arena kind of confused. Either way, it appears that Janivia Smith, after dunking the basketball for 2 points, has fouled out of this contest after receiving a second technical foul of the game. Trey Thomas hits the technical free throw for the Falcons.
Looks like they've taken it back off.
Interesting.
Smith staying on the court, and his fouls count is only reading four.
Does have two technical fouls. His foul count, though, reading at four. Interesting sequence of events, to say the least. So Janivia Smith still in the game for Buffalo. Two technical fouls, four in the game. Trey Thomas bringing the ball for the Falcons. Thomas, the Vanderbilt transfer. Todd Simon has called him the floor general of this Falcons team. He surveys. 10 on the shot clock to E.J. Greer, left wing. E.J. Greer throws this away to Smith. And Fulcher will push it up for Buffalo. Fulcher steps back, thought about a three, does not shoot it off to Smith. And Smith is going to throw this one away, hit in the court afterwards. Not happy with himself on that play. AG will inbound for the Falcons to Trey Thomas. Under 6 minutes to play here at the Stro. Trey Thomas slowing things down for BG. Pass to AG. AG a few feet inside the three-point arc on the right wing. Drives in. Puts a shot up. Does not go. Ball's bounced around off the backboard a few times before Fulcher and Buffalo takes it. Sean Fulcher driving inside. Hesitation move. Left-handed layup. It goes. And one opportunity. Fulcher slid into the bottom of that hoop pretty hard. Taking a second to get up. It appears he'll be okay. He'll go to the line to try to convert a three-point play. This Buffalo team, Holden, not going away. They're just not making much ground up on this Falcons lead.
No, they're trading points for points and getting some good opportunities like this potential three-point play here, but with 5.5 left, it's just not enough speed and urgency to it.
And Altra missing that free throw is not going to help. However, it's going to go off BG as Jason Spurgeon and Rashawn Agee kind of converge trying to get it. It will stay Buffalo ball. Isaiah Adams to inbound. Beside Chapman. Chapman guarded by Spurgeon. Right wing trying to get inside. Spurgeon pokes it away. It goes out of bounds, but it'll be off Spurgeon. 13 seconds remain on the shot clock. Buffalo will inbound once again. Adams inbounding once again. Finds Sable. He thought about pulling a three-pointer right corner. Does not. Retreats back out. Drops it off to Faulcher. Sean Faulcher takes a three-pointer of his own. Comes up way short. And then Janivia Smith on the rebound put up a shot that missed the rim by about a foot and a half. Two very interesting shots there. So now I don't know if we're going to have a foul called, but the official is getting in the middle of a discussion here. Rashawn Agee looks to be appearing to talk to Chapman, not agreeing with some stuff. We will get a foul called, though, not sure on who yet. Marcus Hill to the free throw line for BG. It'll be a 1-1 for Marcus Hill. Hill, a 73.5% shooter on the season, drains the first. That personal foul went on Sean Faulcher, his first of the contest. 5:08 to play in this one. BG up 70-54. Marcus Hill a chance to add another one onto that. He does. 71-54, the new lead for BG, as Dejon Humphrey will check in for Hill.
And with the gap back up to 17, it's once again feeling very, very difficult for Buffalo to get anything going this late. It's anything can happen, but
I would imagine you're not going to see too much more of Marcus Hill in this one. We'll see, though. As now Faulcher gives the ball away to the Falcons. Once again, lost the handle, went out of bounds. BG takes the possession with a chance to build on this lead. This is kind of what you want to see from this Falcons team. Lost three out of the last four, kind of struggling a tad bit, but staying above water. You wanted to see a performance like this to get a solid win against a team that's not really close. You don't have to go to overtime. A solid win appears to be in the books.
And when we talked about this game beforehand, we thought it might look something even different based on the kind of track record that Buffalo has had this season. But in spite of that, over the second half, Bowling Green has been pretty comfortably in control for the majority of the time. And that's definitely the kind of tone you want to set looking ahead to the rest of the season.
Definitely is. Dejon Humphrey, foul called against Buffalo. Shot waved off on the court. It'll be a 1-1. Humphrey nails the first. Humphrey 70, just had over 70% from the line this season. That foul went against Cy Chapman, his third of the game. It's not over just yet. 4:40 left to play in this one, but Falcons maintaining an 18-point advantage. Make it 19 after that free throw rolls in by Humphrey.
A new largest lead of the night for the Falcons, and as time has passed, the lead has now grown. It just doesn't seem like the Bulls are really able to do much to stop the bleeding.
Jason Spurgeon will check out. P.J. Edwards checking in, and just like Hill, I can't imagine you'll see too much more of Spurgeon here tonight. Smith with the ball. He'll pull the mid-ranger. It'll fall. Once again, Buffalo not going away, just not making up much ground. Trey Thomas down low, puts the layup up, does not go. Chapman with the rebound for Buffalo. Faulcher pushing the pace a tad bit. Tries to get around. Agee does not work. Retreats back. Fadeaway jumper. Bingo. 73-58. Falcons lead. Sean Humphrey inside. Puts up a layup. Little floater does not go. Smith tries to block that one, but it's going to be called goaltending. That'll be 2 points for BG.
Once again, the Bulls are trading points for points. They're not getting the stops on defense that they need to try and
cut the deficit to something approachable.
Foster brings the ball up for Buffalo. Kick out to Smith. He'll pull the three-pointer. A little strong off back rim. Does not go. Ryan Sable tries to knock it down, but he'll knock it out of bounds. And we have reached the final media timeout of this one. 3:50 remaining to go here at the Stroh Center. Falcons lead the Bulls 75-58. You're listening to BJSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio. Don't go anywhere.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast, to work hard, to do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
We depend on our drinking water supply daily, but where does that water come from? Your water provider encourages you to get to know your local water source so together we can protect and preserve it. The investments we make as a community to protect our water source now ensure we have a sustainable drinking water supply for the future. Visit drinktap.org to learn more. This message is brought to you by the American Water Works Association and your local water provider.
Tuesday night action contest. Bowling Green up on the Buffalo Bulls 75-58. Bowling Green really just took advantage of the second half, took full control, all momentum swung their way. Started with the last few minutes of the first half, but second half has been all BG.
It has, and when you look at the things that Buffalo has done all season going into this game, the weaknesses are the same ones that are killing them tonight. The turnovers, some inefficiencies from three, aside from a somewhat standout performance from Ryan Sable. They just haven't been able to get much going, especially in the second half. And inside of four here, it looks like they're probably not going to be able to do much.
Marcus Hill back in the game, going to get fouled by Syed Chapman. Bryson Wilson on the foul call. He'll check out for the 6'9" forward, Jonavius Smith. Rashawn Agee checking out for the Falcons. Jason Spurgeon back in this one. He'll hit the free throw from the line. He'll get another attempt. Hill up to 24 points here tonight. Chance to move it up to 25. Very efficient shooting night. 4-for-5 from the line here tonight. Make it 5-for-6.
Once again, the lead's extended to 19. Doesn't look like Buffalo is going to be doing much to cut that deficit.
Now Isaiah Adams going to pull a three. That'll go. Buffalo still not going away. Just like you said, they haven't been able to cut into that deficit much. They're hanging around, though. Down by 16, 77-61. Marcus Hill drives in, dumps it off to P.J. Edwards. He'll put it in. Marcus Hill with his third assist of the game. P.J. Edwards with points 3 and 4.
And a really nice play from Edwards there in traffic.
As now Falcher going to pull up just outside the free throw line, nail jumper. Under 3 minutes to play here on the Bill Frack court at the Stroh Center. Trey Thomas double teamed at half court, pass off to Jason Spurgeon. Spurgeon off to Marcus Hill. He'll drive inside, try to get a shot. Will not go. Spurgeon picks it up and slams it down with two hands. dunk fest here tonight by Jason Spurgeon and Rashawn Agee. Denivia Smith with it out to Ryan Sable. Sable will pull another triple. Ryan Sable with his seventh three-pointer of the night. He's up to 21 points.
Certainly not to be lost in a half that has been pretty much all Bowling Green. Is a pretty standout performance from Ryan Sable for the Bulls.
Now Trey Thomas double-teamed. He will call a timeout. Like you said, Sable just really good shooting performance. 7 for 11 from the field, 7 for 10 from deep. The only Buffalo Bull to crack 20. Just hasn't gotten enough contributions other than that on that. Offense, you look, they do have four guys in double figures, but just hasn't felt like there's been a guy other than him that step up and take over this game with him.
Yeah, and additionally, in the way that Sable's been contributing the most has been purely as the scoring, but he has not been as pivotal in making shots for other guys, getting boards, and they could really use that kind of force that can help push your game forward in multiple ways, in the ways that Rashawn Agee has been tonight for the Falcons. Like you said, the Bulls just don't have a guy who's doing all of that, and that feels like it's been a big difference maker tonight.
They've also been out-rebounded quite heavily. 7 board disadvantage for Buffalo. BG leading that category 36-29. Buffalo does lead offensive rebounds 8-6. They just haven't gotten enough off of those rebounds. Marcus Hill with the ball for the Falcons as the clock approaches. 2 minutes left to go in this one. Hill driving inside. He'll put the layup up, and that'll be blocked by Cy Chapman, but we're going to have a foul called on the court. Actually, not sure exactly what they called there. I believe it's a goaltend call. So that shot will fall for Marcus Hill. Mark him up to 27 points. Falcons leading 83-66. And Hill checks out of the lineup, you'd think, for the last time in this one.
I wouldn't expect to see more of him tonight.
Faulcher with the ball for Buffalo. Slides in and gets a layup. Buffalo still fighting. 1:43 left in this one and counting. Dejon Humphrey double-teamed off to Thomas. They have to get the ball past the timeline. They do. Thomas running the court. Double-teamed once again. And Todd Simon will be forced to call a timeout. So we will take a break with them. Falcons leading 83-68. 1:32 left to go in this contest. You're listening to BJSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
Back here at the Stroh Center, Falcons leading 83-68, seeking their best start since the 2019-2020 season. The world was a lot different the last time the Falcons started this fast on a season. 1:32 left to go in this contest. So the officials are still reviewing something coming out of this 30-second timeout. See what they come up with. Talking with Buffalo head coach George Hilkovich III, first year head coach for Buffalo, spent the past 15 years at Villanova, most recently as an assistant coach to Jay White. He saw two national championships there in his time. Has not been as successful so far in the first season here at Buffalo. Hoping to change tides for this season. Doesn't appear it's going to start tonight. Jason Spurgeon with the ball for the Falcons off to Trey Thomas. Falcons just looking to burn clock time. Thomas going to be fouled by Isaiah Adams. That'll go down as Adams' third foul of this contest. Really the only player in foul trouble right now is Smith. Not that it matters. Smith with four personal fouls. Otherwise, a pretty clean game for both teams in that category.
And to that avail, like you said, with a minute 20 left, stand to miss that. Hardly a factor at this point in this game.
Trey Thomas hits the first one from the line. And Jay-Z Zaher going to check in for the Falcons for DeJuan Humphrey. Zaher last played on December 22nd against Siena Heights. Sophomore guard transfer from Eastern Michigan. Played just two games for Eastern Michigan last season. This is his sixth game for the Falcons this year as Trey Thomas hits the second from the line. Also checking in for the Falcons is Anthony McComb III, who gets a steal. Pass off to Thomas, or to Spurgeon, pardon. Spurgeon into Edwards, off to McComb. McComb gets it up and good. Anthony McComb III also last played on December 22nd against Siena Heights. Gets his first bucket back. B.J. Edwards going to get called for a foul here on the other side for B.G. with 56.8 seconds remaining. And yet another new check-in for the Falcons going to be Greg Spurgeon, the brother of Jason Spurgeon. He'll actually check in for his brother. Greg, the 6'7" forward from Toowoomba, Australia, the sophomore. Fifth game he's appeared in this season. Last played, once again, trio guys last played on December 22nd getting some game action. Falcons have the opportunity up by this much to try to get them some action leading into the back end of the schedule.
And a nice chance to get a little bit of game experience for, again, some guys who aren't always getting to see the court.
And that'll be big come MAC tournament time when you need depth on the team. These guys haven't played in a while, time to get some feel onto their legs. So now Faulcher attacking the rim, gets a layup to go. And Helkovic will call a timeout. Not to the avail of the crowd here at the Shaw Center, but we'll take a break with them. 87-71 with 47.4 seconds remaining in this one. You're listening to BGSU Men's Basketball here on Falcon Radio.
Most of us like to be out in the sun. That's why sunscreen and other safety measures are key to protecting your skin from aging and cancer. The FDA recommends using a sunscreen with an SPF of 15 or higher. Also, look for broad spectrum on the label. That means both harmful ultraviolet A and B rays are blocked. Remember, SPF plus broad spectrum equal healthy fun in the sun. Visit www.fda.gov/sunscreen for more information. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
Buffalo unloading the bench after that last timeout. Falcons currently with three players getting their first game action since December 22nd against Siena Heights. This one all but over. Falcons up by 16 points with 45 seconds left to go. Trey Thomas gets off to P.J. Edwards. Off to Thomas. He gets it across the timeline in time. Thomas still running off to Greg Spurgeon. Left corner. Misses the three. Overshot that one. Didn't hit the rim. Faulcher with it on the other end. This one going to be dropped inside to Zakir Williamson. First action this game, he'll get a bucket to go. Shot clock is off. 20 seconds for the Falcons, and they can just run this one out. Bowling Green going to come away with the victory here tonight. 87-73 will be the final score. Going to secure the most home wins for the Falcons since 2019-2020. In their best record through 23 games and 11 MAC games since that season. Falcons winners here on Tuesday night at the Stroh Center. We'll take a break for a few minutes, get back to you to recap this one. BG winners here tonight, 87-73 over the Buffalo Bulls.
I'm Surgeon General Jerome Adams. If you've recovered from COVID-19 confirmed by a positive test, you're in a special position to help us fight the virus. Your plasma has antibodies that may help others fight COVID. So please donate plasma now. You can literally help save lives. There are locations across the country that have safe ways for you to donate. Find a site to donate your plasma at coronavirus.gov.
Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services at taxpayer expense.
Jill, why don't you tell the class what you did this weekend?
Well, my dad and I went in search of some magical minnows and found a zillion of them in the stream from our lookout rock. Then my sister and I escaped from an evil slug king and went back to my super twig fort for safety. Then we told stories till it got dark, and the Big Dipper led us all the way home.
Wow. Where were you, Jill?
We went to the forest. It's not that far away.
Ask your parents to take you and your friends to the forest this week. It's closer than you think. Check out discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
When someone hears the words, you have cancer, it's one of the darkest moments in their life. Light the Night brings light to the darkness of cancer by uniting survivors, patients, and supporters in the cause to end cancer. We form a community of hope, raising funds in support of the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. The discoveries made by LLS-supported research have led to breakthrough treatments for many cancers and other serious diseases. When we walk, cancer runs. Join the movement to end cancer today. Visit us at lightthenight.org.
Matt always knew he wanted to be a doctor. That's why he makes the most of every day. To study before breakfast. To work hard. To do whatever was necessary to achieve his goal. He found an answer in the military. If you have a passion, a vision for your future in any field, todaysmilitary.com can be your path to a fulfilling career. You have a calling, we have an answer. Find your way at todaysmilitary.com.
Bowling Green winners over Buffalo here tonight at the Stroh Center, 87-73. Joined by my partner Holden Rock, I'm Tyler Campbell. It's in Holden. What are your big takeaways from this contest?
Well, BG kind of stuck to their identity that they've had all year. It was really close going into the halftime, but then in the second half, they really brought it, particularly in their scoring, led by Marcus Hill and Rashawn Agee. Especially Marcus Hill had quite a run in that second half.
Speaking of Marcus Hill, the Mac's leading scorer, 27 points here tonight on an efficient 11-for-16 shooting performance. Hit 5-for-6 from the line, added 6 rebounds and 4 assists in the team high 35 minutes of action. Rashawn Agee added yet another double-double, his 15th straight double-digit scoring performance and his 11th double-double during that span. He added in 18 points and 10 rebounds. Jason Spurge, the big man down low, added in 14 points and 6 rebounds. While Trey Thomas contributed 11 points, 5 rebounds, and a team high 6 assists. Go over to Buffalo side. Buffalo, Ryan Sable had a great night shooting, 7-for-11 from the field, all 7 of those 3-pointers. But not too much after that. Malcher got the points up in the end, 19, but a lot of those were in garbage time. Chapman and Adams both had double digits, 11 and 10 respectively. And if you look at those team percentages, Buffalo shot 44.6% from the field, BG 54.1%. It's not like Buffalo had a bad game. BG just was very efficient all night long.
Yeah, and that's something that they didn't start out as. During the first half, they were not nearly as efficient as their final reflected. But in particular, during the second half, their field goal percentage was 70. And that's a recipe for success.
Falcons also led the rebounding battle 36-31, but this game's not the only final we've had in Mid-American Conference action here tonight. You can take us through some of those finals, Holden.
Yeah, so the Akron Zips came away with a win over the Central Michigan Chippewas, 68-47 tonight.
And that's a really big one. Top two seeds, if the MAC tournament started here today, Akron just solidifying their spot at the top of the standings.
A very big one and quite the convincing win. Meanwhile, Bowling Green took care of business here, of course. As it stands, the Ohio Bobcats and Ball State Cardinals are going into overtime. Meanwhile, Kent State leads the Western Michigan Broncos 61-58 towards the end of the second. Toledo holds a 1-point lead over the Eastern Michigan Eagles with 3 seconds left in that second half. So a lot of action there. Generally speaking, these teams presently in higher position, looking ahead to the MAC tournament, taking care of business, but.
And now you look, Central Michigan still one spot above BG in the standings. Really those top four teams and everybody else right now, Akron, Toledo, Central, and BG, everyone else trying to catch up to them. BG solidifying that spot right now with a win here tonight. Once again, they're end a three-game losing streak against Buffalo. Best start to a season since 2019-2020. And their first home win against Buffalo since December 6th, 2020. So that will do it for us here tonight. BG comes away with the win 87-73. Before we go, a few thank yous I have to give out. First, to Holden Ruck, my partner here tonight. And then also to Chaz McNeil back in the Coolin Studios, board hopping for us. Wouldn't be able to get on the air without you. Thank you for your job here tonight. BG comes away with the win 87-73. Have a good night, everyone.